Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how I handle email. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So this is the first in a series of videos I'm going to do on productivity. More specifically, on things I do to increase my productivity while using Macs. So these are techniques that I personally use. They may or may not fit your needs and style of using computers. But I hope there are some ideas that you can use. So in this episode, I want to talk about email. So this is, of course, my demo account, not my real account here, but I'm going to use it to demonstrate how I handle email. So a lot of people struggle handling email, and I get a ton of email just like everybody else, probably more so. But email really isn't a problem for me because I gave myself some rules many years ago and I followed them. First rule is that my inbox should be empty at all times. Of course, new email comes into the inbox, but when I go to check my email, I make it my goal to clear out my inbox. I know a lot of people don't use their inbox this way. Some people have their inbox filled with things going back days, months, years. Everything just stays in the inbox. I take the inbox literally. It's email that just came into me. And now what I've got to do is take an action with each message in the inbox and get it out of the inbox as quickly as possible. My inbox should be empty when I'm done checking my email. So the default state is there are no messages in it. I like to call this inbox zero, but other people use that same term to mean other things. And another thing I don't do is I don't care about read or unread. Some people use the unread status of an email to show that they need to do something with it. And then when they do something with it, it's just read and it stays in their inbox. I don't care about read or unread. If it's in the inbox, that means it's something I need to deal with as soon as I can. So every email that's in the inbox when I go to check, I look at it and I take an action. The simplest action is to read the email. Sometimes that's all I need to do. Sometimes I need to respond. So that would be the action for that email. Sometimes I need to do other things, like maybe set an event on my calendar. Maybe it's an email about an upcoming appointment. Maybe I need to create a reminder because it's something that I need to take an action on, but I can't do it right now. So I would set a reminder for some point in the future, and then I'm done with that email. Whatever the email message is, there's always an action that you need to take, and then you can get it out of your inbox. And you could always take that action immediately. Even if it's something in the future, you can add a calendar event, a reminder, or something else, and then get the email out. So then what do I do with the email messages? Well, they all go into the archive folder. As a matter of fact, I use the keyboard shortcut message and archive. Control, Command, A, and it goes into archive. Notice what I've got here. I don't have any extra folders. I haven't created a folder for work, for home, for personal, for family, for trips, for tickets, for anything. I don't have any organization in here at all. That wasn't always true. Many years ago, I had a lot of folders there. And every email message I got, I had to figure out where it went. Sometimes it was confusing. Sometimes a message would belong in more than one folder. Sometimes it wouldn't belong in any. And I'd have to think about whether I need to create a new folder to hold this type of email or maybe put it in a miscellaneous folder or something like that. This always takes up a little bit of time for every single email message you get all day long. But if you put it in the archive folder, it takes no time at all. You don't have to think about it. And the message is there for you to find later. So the idea is shift the effort from now, when you're finished reading the email, to later, when you need to find the email later, and you just do a search on your archive. And the reality is that most of the time, you never need to see an email again. It's only occasionally that you need to find an old email. And every single time when I need to find an old email, a search does the trick. You can search for things in the subject, in the body, who it's from, all this stuff, even by date, and figure out where the email is. It usually doesn't take me more than a few seconds to find an email that I need. And the other thing I don't do is I don't put any email in the trash. Now maybe if I was a normal person, I'd put things like obvious spam and scam emails in the trash. But since I kind of keep those around in case I need to do a video on a scam or something, I just put everything into the archive folder. This also saves me from having to decide whether something gets thrown away or archived. A long time ago, I would occasionally throw things away. And you know what? Every once in a while, I'd realize I needed something that I threw away. And today, email providers give you a ton of storage space. So even with all the email I get, I've never come close to running out of storage. So that's it. That's how I deal with email. The rules are that Every time I check my email, my goal is to empty my inbox completely. To remove an email from my inbox, I read it and take an action. And then everything goes into the archive folder where if I do need it later, I can search for it. And if I don't, it's really not going to get in my way. And that's how I have an empty inbox all the time, and email for me is never stressful. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.